What are organizational process assets? What are enterprise environmental factors? You might have read the definition of OPA and EEF, but do you understand the difference between OPA and EEF? Let's figure it out. Hey, this is Praveen Malik from PMbyPM.com, your ultimate resource for the PMP exam prep. I have made it my mission to help you pass the PMP exam in your first try. Today, I'm going to talk about organizational process assets and enterprise environmental factors with the help of a few examples. Stay tuned till the end of this video and I'll share a key with you which will help you to distinguish between OPA and EEF. Before we go ahead, please subscribe to this channel and click on bell icon. This way, whenever I release a new informative video, you'll get an instant notification. So what are organizational process assets? Let's look at the definition. Organizational process assets, OPAs, are the plans, processes, policies, procedures, and knowledge bases specific to and used by the performing organization. These assets influence the management of the project. Now at the first glance, this definition looks kind of cumbersome, but let's look at the keywords. The keywords are plans, processes, policies, procedures, and knowledge bases to be used by the performing organization. Now, performing organization is the one which is doing a project. And we are talking about some plan, processes, and policies, some kind of documentation. The OPAs can be broadly categorized into two parts. These are processes, policies, and procedures, and organizational knowledge bases. So let's take a look at some example to understand it further. In the first category, you will have all types of documents. For example, templates, checklists, forms, plans, procedures, policies, etc. Templates could include templates for client reporting, for weekly status report, for project performance report. There could be templates for minutes of the meetings, templates for schedule development, and many other things. The second category could include data and knowledge repositories from previous projects. For example, lessons learned data, financial data, issue and defect management data, and many more things. Now let's take a look at enterprise environmental factors. Enterprise environmental factors refer to conditions not under the control of project team that influence, constrain, or direct the project. These conditions can be internal and or external to the organization. Again, this definition looks kind of cumbersome, but let's look at some of the keywords. It says conditions not under the control of the project team. So any condition that is outside the project, whether within the organization or outside the organization, that can influence the project in some way is considered as enterprise environmental factor. Again, these can be broadly categorized into two heads. These are external and internal. Let's take a look at a few examples. So internal could be organizational culture, structure, and governance. It could be infrastructure, physical infrastructure, which includes the office space, the building, the furniture, etc. It could mean the computer infrastructure, the technology and the software infrastructure. The external factors could include the competitive environment, the marketplace conditions, the social and culture outside the organization, legal restrictions, and many more things. Now you will notice that hardly any one of these is under the project team's control. So we can't do anything about them. What's the difference between OPA and EEF? Let's revisit the definitions. So any kind of plan, process, policies, etc. can be categorized as OPA. So we can say any documentation that is helpful for the project team can be construed as OPA. Whereas conditions which are not under the control of project team can be construed as EEF. Now there's a catch here. You might say that you do not have control over some of the documents like guidelines, but they are considered as OPAs. Why? Okay, you might not have control over the guidelines, but you certainly have control over your project. You can tailor those guidelines to suit your projects. That is why one of the OPA is tailoring guidelines. But on the other hand, you do not have any influence over the culture of the organization or social structure of the organization. You do not have any influence over the legal matters or the government policies. So they are construed as EEF. So what is the key for distinguishing between OPA and EEF? OPAs are some sort of documents. EEFs are some sort of conditions. A condition may be within the organization or outside the organization. Documents are used by the projects and help the projects. Conditions influence the project, sometimes negatively, sometimes positively. An easy way to remember the condition is to remember this acronym, PESL. PESL means political, economical, social, technological, legal, environmental. So if you remember this acronym, you might be able to understand what is EEF. Just remember this, any document that you use for your project can be considered as OPA, and any condition that influences your project can be considered as EEF. To end, I have a question for you. You might have heard about Project Management Information System. So is Project Management Information System an OPA or EEF? I'm curious to know. Please comment below. I would love to hear your answer. Thank you. You can follow me on Facebook, Quora, and LinkedIn. The links are in the description below. Before you go, please like and share this video and subscribe to this channel. Thank you once again.